Hi there, good to see you on Circuit Digest. I'm Prathmesh, your host and dost, and today we will learn how to create a server, an ESP32 web server on an Arduino IDE. We'll then use this web server to control an LED connected to the ESP32. This tutorial is perfect for beginners who want to learn how to create a simple web server and control an LED using the ESP32. But before that, let's understand what an ESP32 is. The ESP32 is a low-cost microcontroller board that features Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity and is commonly used for IoT projects. It can be used for a variety of applications such as home automation, sensor networks, robotics, and wearable technology. With its wireless connectivity and processing power, the ESP32 is well-suited for projects involving data collection, analysis, and communication over the internet. Now let's summarize what we will be doing in this tutorial. First, we will be interfacing the LEDs to a microcontroller. Secondly, we will code the ESP32 and then we will try to access the web page by inputting IP address in the browser. And third, we will test our web server by clicking the on and off buttons.
Let's go over the materials which we will require. ESP32 board, USB cable, LEDs and resistors, and a few jumper wires.
So we are going to connect the ESP32 and LED on this breadboard. The resistors are used to limit the current going through the LEDs. We will interface the ESP32 with two LED lights connected to GPIO pin 12 and 14. Here's how to interface the ESP32 with two LED lights. Connect one end of a 220 ohm resistor to GPIO pin 12 on the ESP32 and connect the other end of the resistor to the positive leg of one LED light. Connect the negative leg of the LED light to the ground on the ESP32. Repeat steps 1 and 2 for GPIO pin 14 and the other LED light. Now let's move on to the Arduino IDE. If this is the first time that you are using ESP32 with Arduino IDE, you need to click on the card shown above and follow the procedure and then come back again to this point. If you've already configured Arduino IDE, you can move on to the next step. To upload any code, you just need to copy or write the code on the IDE. Verify or compile it and upload it to the board. Here's a blinking LED as an example. Now let's put our main web server code in Arduino IDE. Just copy and paste. Make sure that before uploading you replace the SSID and password with your hotspot name and password. And we are done. After the code is uploaded, let's open the serial monitor and find the IP address of the ESP32 module, which is here. Try resetting the board once if you couldn't find it. Now open a web browser and type in the IP address of the ESP32. You can see how the LED turns on as soon as I click on the button and how it shuts off again as I press it again. Also notice how the state of the LED is continuously updated on the web page. But how does this project works? The ESP32 is connected to a Wi-Fi network, which is my phone's hotspot currently, allowing it to communicate with client's devices over the network. When my phone connects to the ESP32's IP address, the web server code serves a web page to my phone's web browser. The web page contains control for the LED lights, allowing me to turn them on or off. When I interact with the controls on the web page, the ESP32 microcontroller receives the command and adjusts the LED light accordingly. The ESP32 sends a response back to my phone, updating the web page with the current state of the LED lights. So to summarize, in this tutorial we learned about the powerful ESP32 microcontroller, we learned how to interface LEDs to ESP32 and how to upload code on it. Later we learned how to create our own web server and control the LEDs. We can also try this tutorial with a relay module to control a real light bulb. Make sure to try this out and let me know in the comment section.
Also, I would like to thank all of you guys for supporting us in this journey and for us to reach 50k subscribers. So thanks to each one of you for that. And that's it. If you like our content, make sure to subscribe to our channel. If you don't like it, make sure to follow us on Instagram. See you in the next one.